Hi, I'm Ernie Conover. Pens are probably one of the most popular turning projects. In this video, I'd like to show you some things that you can actually do better on the lathe than off of it. Most pen kits require drilling of a center hole through your blank into which a brass tube is glued. The parts of the pen are then a press fit with this tube and the whole thing stays together. Center drilling this blank straight is problematic and a drill press is not the best tool to do this with. Your lathe will do much better. Because most holes end up a bit crooked, they're not straight, the holes that are specified for the kits are generally rather oversized. Having first been trained as a machinist, I like a little less slop in my tolerances. Therefore, I generally drill my blanks with number, letter, or fractional drills to get a little tighter tolerances. For instance, this kit calls for a 7mm drill, which would be 2765. In thousandths. The tube is 0.266 for an outside diameter, so this leaves 10 thousandths of slop. Instead, I use an eye drill, which is 272 thousandths or plus 6. Tightens things up a little. If you're lucky enough to own a four-jaw chuck, you can simply mount your blank in the chuck, start up the lathe with the drill mounted in the tailstock, and drill your blank. And an oddity of drilling in a lathe is that with the work turning, the drill tends to center better. By securing our drill in a drill chuck mounted in the headstock and pushing the piece against this drill with a live center mounted in the tailstock, we can get a perfectly straight bore with the axis of this blank. By holding it in a clamp like this, we get a little more safety out of the operation, and we will drill approximately halfway from one direction and the rest of the way from the other. You notice that I'm backing out and clearing the drill frequently, make for a much more accurate hole. In wood, most drills tend to drill a bit oversized. For this slimline hardware kit, I had to cut the blank in half after center drilling. And into the center hole, we now push a brass bushing. I put a line on my blank so that I can align the grain properly during the final turning and assembly of the pen. Before gluing, it's always a good idea to rough the tube up a little bit with some sandpaper. That ensures that we have a little more tooth for the glue to stick to. The directions also tell you not to get any glue on the inside of the tube. But a great trick is to just take a little bit of potato, push the blank into a potato, and that effectively puts a plug on this that will prevent the glue from getting inside. So there I've put it on, and I'll now just put that in, and I'll spin this as I go down through. And there, we're all set. Our next job is to shorten the ends of our blocks, which we cut a little bit too long, and to bring them down to the length of the brass tube and make the ends perfectly square to the axis of the tube. That's easier said than done, but there's a nifty tool available, which is just a mill here with a center shaft that will also clean the glue or potato in this case out of the center. It's safest to do this job with a clamp by simply slipping that over starting up your lathe and now pushing on it. And just keep watching that you're getting down to where you need there. I've just touched the tube, and now I'll do the other end. Our trimmed blanks are now mounted on a pen-turning arbor with bushings between the pieces to space them out and give us the minimum diameter we may turn to. We bring our tailstock up, lock it, and stabilize that arbor. We now have a very easy job of turning these concentric with a bore. Now that we have our two halves turned, sanded, and finished, I used pure shellac and then carnauba wax to finish these two halves. And we are now ready to press our pen together. And most texts tell you to do this in a bench vise or a pen vise, but I'm actually going to use our lathe to do this task. Your lathe also makes a great arbor press. I've double side taped two squares of wood to the spindles. I took a pencil and drew a little circle, which gives me the center, and I can just put that right there like that and bring this up and press the two together just as nice as can be and have complete axial alignment throughout the whole process. No end to the fun that you can have turning pens.